Hello and welcome back to here in Produal Academy. My name is Antti Salli and I'm a product manager here in Produal. Today we will take a look on MLB Modbus LoRaWAN bridge products. These are designed to read any Modbus RTU device to the LoRaWAN network. So let's hop in. Here we have two MLBs, MLB and an MLB. The main difference between these two devices is that the MLB comes with the internal antenna and the MLB ANT comes with the external antenna connector. Here we have a close look on MLB ANT. On the top we have an antenna connector SMI with an external antenna. Here in the inside we have a power connectors G and G0 for 24 AC or DC power supply. Then we have A plus and B minus connectors for the RS485 Modbus RTU. Here we can see RX and TX LED blinking, and this blinking tells us that the MLB is now asking from the bus the registers, but there is no device connected. When there is a device connected on a bus line, this LED will blink more faster when there is accepted replies from the slave device to the MLB. Also, we have a power LED and two cable glands for bringing the power supply cable in and the Modbus cable. MLB is a device that works in public and private LoRaWAN networks. All the configuration to the MLB is done with the MyTool application. With MLB, we are using NFC connectivity. NFC you can find from the main screen of the MyTool, NFC devices. NFC can be found from the left side of the MLB. When I have activated the NFC functionality from the MyTool, I can bring my phone here on the left side, put on the top of it, and now we have created a connection to the MLB. NFC connection is so-called passive connection, so all the settings that we are doing, we need to push on the NFC by bringing the phone back on the NFC tag after we have made all the changes. All the MLB settings is done from the configure manually part. The best way to get the understanding of how MLB is working is so that I will go through all the phases of setting new Modbus RTU device under the MLB, and then we are connecting it to the LoRaWAN network. First, we will select Modbus device list. From here, we can add devices under the MLB. One MLB supports up to 16 independent Modbus RTU devices. As an example, I will add one TRC room controller under the MLB. So let's start. We select Add Device, Modbus Slave Device ID 1. So we have configured Modbus Slave ID 1 to this TRC. We select Next. In this case, I don't have ready-made configuration file for this TRC, so I will use generic Modbus device. After this, I click Add. Now I have selected this generic Modbus device, and now I can start to configure Modbus registers. To edit the Modbus registers, we will go under the payload editor. From here, we can see that we have a payload, registers, and then source and register parameters. One MLB can handle up to four payloads, and each payload includes 8 16-bit registers. Here I have selected payload, and the payload is part of transmit group 1. I will go a little bit later through what the transmit group means. Let's start to edit register number 1. So we have selected source, and this is now the slave ID 1 generic Modbus device. Then we can configure what is the used register function, input register, holding register, or discrete input or coil. In this case, I will use input register. Next, I will give the register address. In this case, I want to read example temperature, and let's assume that the temperature can be found from register number 100. So I will give 100 as a register number or register address. After that, we can select what is the data type, unsigned 16, signed 16, or unsigned 32, or signed 32. if we are using 16-bit registers, those are taking one slot from the payload. If you have a 32-bit registers, the 32-bit register will take two register slots out from the payload. But in this case, we have a 16-bit register, so let's use that. NDNS adjustment is how we are reading the register. Usually we are using none, but if there is a register that we want to read from the last bit to the first one, we are using this 16-bit inversion. COV limit, this is a change of value, and usually if we have a COV activated from this transmit group setting, we can give some kind of a COV for the measurement. This means that the COV can activate the payload that is sent to the LoRaWAN network. When we are happy with the settings, we can click Confirm Changes and push these settings to the MLB. Next, we will take a look on transmit group settings. Each payload is following the time or the send interval to the LoRaWAN network based on the transmit groups. We can do it so that each payload has its own transmit group, or we can use one transmit group for all the payloads. How it is working is that we can adjust the payload sent based on time, change of value, or both. 3 minutes is fastest time interval that we can have for one payload. What it means is that we need to wait 3 minutes until we can send new payload. Let's assume that we are using 8 registers in first payload. What this means is that when we have selected 3 minutes interval, the payload is sent to the LoRaWAN network every 3 minutes. When we have 8 registers, we can fit those in one payload. When we have more than 8 registers, we need to activate second payload. When we are activating second payload, this means that the payload 1 is sent, and after 3 minutes we are sending payload 3. Then we can send again payload 1. So this will create 6 minutes interval for payload 1 and 2. If we are using all 4 payloads, the interval is 12 minutes. Under the communication, we can find Modbus settings. From the Modbus settings, we can set baud rate, data bits, parity, stop bits, Modbus timeout, and also delay between pods. Under the LoRaWAN settings, we can find device enabled, LoRaWAN data rate mode, LoRaWAN activation mode, and join AOE. Usually, MLB is coming from the factory in disabled mode. So remember to activate and click enabled before taking MLB on use. LoRaWAN data rate mode is something that we recommend to use as adaptive. LoRaWAN activation mode is OTA, but we are also supporting ABB way of activation. And the last one is join AOE. Under the general communication settings, we can give a device name for the MLB. When we are happy with all settings, we will click install to device and take my tool here on the NFC of MLB. Now all the settings is sent to the MLB. Next, we will take a look how to use description files when adding devices under the MLB. In this case, we don't have a description file ready-made for TRC, so I will show you how you can create your own description files to any Modbus device that you are adding under the MLB. To create your own description file, you need to go mytool.produal.com. You can use the same credentials that you are using with MyTool. After you have logged in, you can go under the configurations, and from here we find MLB device profiles. Here you can create your own description files. So in this case, we are adding TRC. Let's start by selecting create a new device profile. I will give a name of TRC. And the model of this TRC is TRC-3A mod, so I'm using that. Device type can be Produal third party or user device, and in this case I'm selecting user device. Manufacturer is Produal. Under the device category, I can select from different kind of device types, And in this case, I'm using a room controller for this. To the firmware version, you can use the firmware of the device, or you can put just something from your own head. In this case, I'm just using numbers once. And after we are ready, we can select create. New MLB device profile created successfully. So now we have added TRC3A mod under the room controllers. Next, we will start to add registers. So I will select edit. Here we can see that we have a discrete inputs, coils, input registers and holding registers. Let's say that we want to read temperature register from the TRC, so we will add it one under the input registers. So I will select add register. Here in the first, what I need to do is to add the register, and let's assume that it's 30,100. Then I will give a name, temperature, and description. Let's use internal temperature. After we have give a description, we will select register type. And in this case, I'm using Cygnet 16. After we have given register type, we will select value unit. In this case, we are using temperature. From the scale, we can select how the register is scaled. When we are happy with all the settings, we will select save changes. Now we have created a register under the TRC. After we have saved the device profile, we can find it from the My tool under the MLB device profiles. After you have created a description file, remember to log out and log into the My tool. This will refresh the MLB device profile list. Now, what we will do first is we will select Modbus device list. Here, add device, number one. And now we have created this profile, so we will find it under the user devices. We selected Produal as a manufacturer, room controller as a profile, and here we can find TRC3A mod that we just created in the web page. I will select the TRC and click add. Now I'm happy with all the settings and I will select confirm changes. Now when we are going to the payload editor, we can see under the source slave ID 1 is TRC3A mod. To select the temperature register, we need to select register and here temperature. Choose, and now you can see all the settings is going gray. So is it using exactly those same settings that we were creating on the web page? When we are happy with all the settings, we click confirm changes, and now we are ready to push all the settings to the device. If you have a project where is coming several similar MLBs with exactly the same configuration, we can save the configuration and copy paste it to the next MLBs that we are adding to the network. How to do this? First, we save configuration and we will save it to the cloud. To use ready-made configuration file, we will select install existing configuration, and here I'm selecting from the MyCloud. From here you can see Produal Academy is the file that we just created. I will select load and edit. It will ask what settings we are importing to the new MLB. I will select all of these and click load configuration. Now, this Produal Academy name configuration is active on our My tool, and every time when we push the phone next of the empty MLB, it will push exactly this setting file to that MLB. Like here in example. And we get the notification that this configuration was put successfully into the MLB. This is the way how you can use one configuration file in multiple MLBs. Now we have put settings to the MLB. MLB is now reading temperature from the TRC. I have connected to this MLB to our private LoRaWAN network, which is using the Things network backend. I have now here in the TTN backend, and here we can see the payload that is coming from the MLB. Here you can see all the Modbus registers in hex format. The first register that we are reading is showing us the temperature of the TRC. That was all from this time, so thank you for watching Produal Academy. I hope that you get lots of new information about our products. See you in the coming episodes.